What's up, guys, and welcome back to my Breath of the Wild Any% No Amiibo Speedrun tutorial series and the second to last chapter, number 9, where we talk about how to fight the four blights guarding Calamity Ganon since we came here without beating any of the divine beasts. Learning and practicing blights can become incredibly frustrating since every time you die you will have to start over from the very first of the four blights again. Take advantage of that though and try to keep your head up. Every time you die during Blight's practice, consider it another chance to increase your consistency and learn new things about Blights. A couple of general things at the start here. Blights have a fair bit of RNG to them, even to an extent that I, after finishing Blights over hundreds of times, still encounter new patterns. I'm going to try to cover most patterns, but always be on guard and make sure to ask questions here in the comments and in the Breath of the Wild speedrunning server linked in the description. Another thing to go over again is Link's one-shot protection. If you are at full health, Link has one-shot protection for most attacks. Since the attacker potion refills your hearts, you can get it once in these fights, but you really want to avoid that since that is gonna make Calamity a lot harder. The attacks that ignore one-shot protection I will specifically talk about. Also keep in mind that your attack up potion has a timer on it, which is most likely gonna be 5 minutes and 10 seconds long. This potion has to last the entire Blights and Ganon fight. So as a goal, you want to finish Blights with around 2.5 minutes of duration left. From here, I will play each phase of the Blights in full speed first, then cover how to do them optimally, and then talk about what to do if things go unoptimally. At the start of Windblade Phase 1, you want to climb this wall on the entrance of the arena. This will manipulate Windblade into shooting his laser cannon, giving us an opening to close the gap. As soon as Windblade appears, jump away from the wall by holding your control stick in the opposite direction of the wall and pressing X, then immediately open your glider and glide straight towards Windblade. Don't be scared of him shooting and try to dodge. That will actually be the only way you get hit. So glide straight towards him, actually. As soon as you are directly in front of Windblade, close your glider and drink your level 3 attack up potion. Attack Windblade 7 times with your Royal Guard's sword. The first 4 attacks will be a full combo. After 3 additional attacks, you want to jump to cancel Link's long animation for the 4th hit. During this jump, switch to the Royal Claymore and hold away from Windblade so Link faces his back to him. Start a back-facing spin attack while holding away from Windblade so you get double hits until phase 1 is completed. Make sure to keep holding away from Windblade while you start your spin attack or Link will automatically turn around, making double hits impossible. Once you are spinning, you can move in close to assure the hits. The element of randomness in Windblade Phase 1 is his initial spawn position. You should turn your camera towards the arena to see where he is gonna appear. Good RNG is if Windblade spawns close to you. An optimal completion should be easy in this case. If Windblade spawns far away from you, there is a high chance that he is gonna start throwing tornadoes during your spin attack. You really have to make sure to dodge them. I personally slightly steer my spin attack to the left to make sure I don't get hit by his tornado, but sometimes you just get hit and it feels really bad losing a run that way. Because if you get hit by a tornado, you are in trouble. Not only are you gonna miss the one cycle on Windblight, but the second phase will be pretty much a full-on RNG fest and you'll have to finish the game with a quarter heart. Depending on Link's position towards Windblight during the final hit of phase 1, Windblight is gonna have a different starting action in phase 2. So let's get into phase 2 to talk about that. Optimally, Windblight will be right in front of you preparing for a cannon attack when you start off phase 2. We want to headshot him 3 times with the Royal Guard's bow. Make sure to move as close as possible to him during these shots since we want to run past him directly after the third headshot hits, and if we are too far away from him, his arm may block us. While running behind him during him falling, switch to the Royal Guard's spear. When he's fully on the ground and you are behind him, target Windblight with ZL and attack him 4 times with your spear. Wait a tiny bit before you throw out a 5th attack, since if you just spam, the animation of the 5th attack will be very long and obviously slower. Keep targeting Windblight and move into this position while charging up an attack by holding the Y button. As soon as the charge is up to level 2, and as soon as you hear the charge sound the second time, let go of Y and the attack should finish Windblight off. Let's go into the things that you could encounter here. As mentioned, Windblight Phase 2 has 3 different openings depending on how close you were to him during the last hit in Phase 1. If you end Phase 1 too close to Windblight, he will start Phase 2 by throwing tornadoes at you. Optimally, you could headshot him before he throws them, but this is incredibly hard and risky, the timing is super tight. So the best thing to do here, when you spot his tornado animation, which after some practice you will be able to tell when he's throwing tornadoes at you, the best thing to do there is running behind Windblight, where you should be safe and wait until his tornadoes disappear, then start the 3 headshots from there and play as usual. If you end phase 1 too far away from Windblight, he's gonna start phase 2 by voiding out. Even though this is slower, this is not a big risk. Just wait until he appears again and then start from there with your headshots. Your spear could break during the charge attack, which is gonna affect the first phase of the next blight, Water Blight. This can only happen if a charge hit hits one of the Windblight Ganon cannons swirling around him, which loses double durability on your spear, even though you only deal damage once. If your spear breaks before you can successfully finish the one cycle, Windblight will void out. Wait until he appears again and finish him off with headshots, keeping in mind that this is also an arrow and bow durability loss. This should be everything about Windblight though, so practice that and let's move on to Waterblight. The first thing to mention during Water Blight is that you can already move while the game is fading back in after skipping a cutscene. Optimally, at the start of Water Blight, you will have your spear, so already hold towards Water Blight during the fade in after the cutscene skip, so Link walks up. I move towards him until the game is fully faded in and then target and attack him with my spear, which should break after the first hit, dealing double damage. As soon as the spear breaks, switch to the Stone Smasher and hit Waterblight Ganon 2 times, immediately cancelling the second hit with a jump to Waterblight's side, in which you will be safe from his spear thrust attack that he should be throwing out. After he attacked you, you want to position here and start spin attacking, facing your back to Waterblight's arm, which will optimally give you triple hits, 1 on his body and 2 on his arm. In the best case, this will end phase 1 before you run out of stamina. Let's again get into the things that you could encounter here. If you don't have your spear at the start of this fight, immediately switch to the Stone Smasher, run up towards Waterblight a bit and just start the fight with 2 untargeted Stone Smasher hits and then dodge his spear thrust to keep playing normally from there. Don't sweat it if you don't hit him twice and only once, you should still be fine as long as you dodge his spear and start your spin attack in time. If Waterblight doesn't throw out his spear thrust and instead prepares for his AoE shockwave, run away as fast as you can. Wait far away from him until he goes for the spear thrust again and dodge that by running to his side, then start spin attacking him from here, hoping for triple hits to still get a one cycle. This AoE shockwave will only happen if you ran too close to Waterblight before your very first hit, so make sure to stay far enough away from him so you can barely hit him, but not too close or he will throw out his shockwave, losing a lot of time on your potion and your run. If you don't get many or any triple hits, chances are you won't be able to finish him off with one spin attack. If that's the case, let go of Y just before you run out of stamina. The resulting slam should make Water Blight collapse, allowing you to finish him off with single hits. After he collapses, you have time for 4 single hits and then 1 jump attack, damaging Water Blight twice, once from the attack and once from the ground slam. If you still can't finish Water Blight off in time, he's gonna void out, so wait until he reappears again, then finish him off with a spin attack. Let's move on to phase 2. At the beginning of phase 2, Water Blight will void out no matter what. During that downtime, I switch to the Lizzle Try Boomerang and already to the Square Bomb, which will be used for the Fire Blight later. I then run towards the throne in the Sanctum Arena, which increases the chance that Water Blight moves towards the other direction. I will talk later about why this is extremely helpful and almost needed. As soon as Water Blight appears, headshot him 2 times to make him fall down, immediately running after him to get the most amount of damage in. Optimally, hit him 6 times with your boomerang, briefly waiting after the 3rd hit to not get the long animation on the 4th one during a combo. After the 6th hit registered, target Water Blight as he's moving back to the ceiling and throw your boomerang at him, which you then instantly pick back up. Follow Windblight as he's moving towards the other side of the arena. If he's directly next to the throne, slightly position on the side, so he actually falls to the floor instead of onto the throne, where he will be untargetable unless you waste arrows. After 2 more headshots, he falls to the floor again, and if you did everything optimally, a jump attack will finish him off. Now for potential backup strats and things you may encounter again. The first thing I want to emphasize on again is the situation where Water Blight is close to the throne. Really make sure to headshot him from the side to make sure he doesn't fall to that spot up there, which will lose a lot of time and arrows. So definitely make sure to find the throne at the start of the phase to move towards it, making Water Blight go to the opposite side. Another thing that can happen at the start is that Water Blight falls down after your first headshot. Now this is actually optimal, but not consistent. If that does happen, everything can be played normally other than the end. Instead of finishing Water Blight off with a jump attack, finish him off with a spinning attack since you need 1 more hit here. The boomerang throw can miss, and if you aim it badly, the boomerang can fly to one of the balconies, completely messing you up since this won't be the last time we need the boomerang. When you start out, you can just skip this boomerang throw and instead finish Water Blight off with a spin attack. That should be the most important information about Water Blight. Regardless of how the fight goes, make sure to finish it with the Stone Smasher equipped, since we will absolutely need it for Fire Blight. So let's move on. While the game is fading back in from the cutscene skip for Fire Blight, make sure to already hold your left stick towards him and then as soon as you can see the game, press Y once, and as soon as Link pulls out the Stone Smasher, hold Y. This is to make Link spin attack as fast as possible. You want to spin until your Stone Smasher hits Fire Blight 3 times and then let go of Y, so Link slams down, which will stun Fire Blight briefly. Now repeat, go for another spin attack and hit Fire Blight 3 times again and slam again. This time, Fire Blight will collapse on the ground. Switch to your Royal Guard's sword and as soon as you can, target Fire Blight, hitting him until your sword breaks, which should end phase 1. As long as you start spinning early enough, you should be fine in this phase, and I would say this is one of the easiest phases in Blights. The problem is if you do start spinning too late and Fireblight hits you before you can slam down your sword after 3 successful hits, he will hit you. And this specific attack is one of the ones that ignores one-shot protection, so you will die. Another possible mistake is that your spin attack hits Fireblight 3 times in a row super quick. If you notice that is happening, delay your slam attack a little bit or otherwise he may not get stunned. Other than that, Fireblight phase 1 is really straightforward. So let's move on with phase 2. In phase 2, Fireblight will instantly void out and appear in the air with his protecting shield applied. Run to the center of the arena and drop a squared bomb, also switching to the boomerang. Once Fireblight appears, move close to him and wait until he sucks the bomb towards him, blowing it up in his reach, making Fireblight fall to the ground. Move in close, in position between the right arm and his head here, then hit him 3 times with the boomerang and jump to cancel the animation. Switching to the Royal Claymore mid-jump, you can then turn your back towards Fireblight and start a spin attack in this position, hopefully getting as many double hits as possible. Optimally, you can one-cycle Fireblight here with enough hits just before he voids out to finish off the third Blight. There's 2 common issues during the phase, the super common first one being missing the one cycle. If you don't get enough hits during your spin attack, Fireblight will get up and void out before you can finish him off. When this happens, you will have full stamina again when he reappears, so you can already time your spin attack when he comes back to then finish him off that way. Another issue is that Fireblight sometimes randomly gets up super early after the knockdown from the bomb. When that happens, wait until he reappears and headshot him twice to make him collapse, allowing you to finish off the fight with the spin attack as usual. Since we once again need the Royal Claymore at the start of Thunderblight, make absolutely sure that you end this fight with it equipped. Thunderblight is extremely dangerous and most people really dislike him, even casually, so destroying him fast feels really good. Keep in mind that all Thunderblight sword attacks ignore one-shot protection and straight up one-shot you. Here is the optimal phase 1. Sprint up this time, actually holding B towards Thunderblight during the cutscene fade-in and hit him twice with your Royal Claymore when in range. This will break his shield. Now jump, turn around and hit him 5 times with a spin attack. 1 hit in the first rotation and 2 hits in the second and third rotation and then let go of Y to slam down. Now turn around again so you face him and spin attack again, this time only hitting him twice, once per rotation and then slamming down again. Thunderblight should now get up, walk back and headshot him without getting hit by his electro bolts. This should optimally end phase 1. If you miss breaking Thunderblight's shield at the start, he will start zooming around, trying to attack you. Make sure to flurry rush this attack and then break his shield, giving you one more chance to play the fight normally from there. The same thing can happen if you take too long to slam on any of your spin attacks. Really make sure to keep track of the hits you are getting during this phase. If you missed 2 hits during the spins, for example, you are gonna have to hit Thunderblight 2 more times after the headshot. The headshot will make him collapse to the ground though, so in this window you can go for the hits if you missed some earlier. If you miss too many hits though, Thunderblight gets up after his collapse from the headshot, you might mess up phase 2 that way and get a real problem later. But let's move on to phase 2 and talk about that there. Thunderblight flies up, preparing to attack you with his electric poles. These poles, when electrified, will ignore one-shot protection and kill you, but don't be scared. Just switch to your boomerang and wait in place, going into throw aim, aiming at Thunderblight's shield. Wait until all poles fell to the ground, cause you can otherwise miss this upcoming throw by the boomerang being blocked by the poles. And now throw your boomerang against Thunderblight's shield, which will stun him mid-air. Then headshot him, which will make him fall to the floor. Pick up your boomerang and hit Thunderblight 4 times to break his shield, then jump to cancel the animation. Switch to the Royal Claymore mid-jump and then face your back to Thunderblight, getting double hits on him until he dies. Optimally, your sword does not break here because we can make use of it in Calamity later. But if it breaks, it's fine, we can use another strat in Calamity instead. Sometimes really stupid things can happen in this phase, like Thunderblade's metal pillars blocking your boomerang even on the ground for no reason, so this phase is always scary. If you break Thunderblade's shield but miss a headshot, you have time for one more, and after he zooms around the arena, even for one more. So take your time to make sure you hit the headshot. If Thunderblight gets up during your boomerang hits, you most likely made a mistake in phase 1 and now have to dodge his electro bolts or dash attacks to break his shield and then end the fight that way. These should be the most common events in Thunderblight Ganon. That's it. Once you are through these blights, you will encounter Calamity Ganon, which obviously deserves his own video. And this is where it gets really intense, but make sure to practice blights a lot, and I mean a crazy amount. This section is super scary and important in a run, cause a mistake can lose you so much time. But I believe you can do this, and trust me, it feels so good to go through this boss rush without even getting hit. Make absolutely sure to join the speedrunning Discord for questions about blight fights. I covered a lot, but they still do so much random things that everyone will still encounter a special pattern, so make sure to ask about it in the Discord. You can also always come by my stream where I currently learn a new speedrun category of this game. So if you want to say hi and watch me learn something too, the link is in the description. See you next week when we destroy Calamity and Dark Beast Ganon and finish Breath of the Wild as fast as possible. I believe in you guys. See you there.